Rika. Good evening, good evening, beloved. Good night. I greet you all in Jesus' name. Welcome this evening to our session. I just want to remind us this evening that while I am on Facebook doing the live, most of the time I want to be teaching the Word of God. I love standing up to preach. When I sit down, I want to teach. Amen. Bless God. I welcome every one of you all this evening. I am Pastor Anil Mankan from the God Will Provide Ministry. My wife Lydia Mankan, the assistant pastor. So this evening I want to start as we worship this wonderful song. I love this song, Too Bad Folks. The goodness of God. Let's hear it for a couple of minutes before we start. All my life, all our life, all my life, God have been faithful, beloved. Is He faithful with you? Is He faithful to you? Every breath. Hallelujah. We'll sing for the goodness of God. Hallelujah. God is good, beloved. I don't know for you, but God is good. He's good to me. He is so good to me, beloved, that I can't help myself sometimes but to share the goodness of God. And this evening, I want to encourage you this evening, those who are looking and listening. Equip yourself. Get into the Word of God. Equip yourself. And go on Facebook or somewhere and share the Word of God. Amen. This is a time people need knowledge, beloved, on the Word of God. Go deep in the Word. Get revelation. And let God use you. Amen. So as we worship, we hear this beautiful song. I want to encourage the body this evening that you are a vessel. You are a channel for God, beloved. Amen. You could bring change to people's life. All of us could be a blessing to each other. Don't wait on the pastors or the leaders. The Spirit of God is upon you to preach the Word, to teach the Word. Amen. Let's pray. Let's pray before I go further, beloved. Father, I thank you, God, for your goodness this evening upon us, oh God. Again, God, we give you praise, we give you honor. Lord, and I give you glory this evening. I thank you, Lord, again, for the opportunity to come to share your Word today. And as I sit here this evening, oh God, I pray for your anointing upon my life. As I humble myself before you, God, as a servant, oh God, I am nothing without you, Lord. And I thank you for your Holy Spirit in my life this evening, oh God, that will empower me, oh God, to share your Word. That people could mature, could grow, Father. As Paul said in the book of Colossians, that the believers need to mature. He need them to be mature and to grow spiritually. Father, I thank you, Lord. Oh God, as I come to share, Lord, I pray, Lord, that every person that hear my voice, going to listen this Word today, that you have for them, Lord. And they're going to apply the Word upon their life, Father. That, Lord, they will be fruitful. Lord, they will get wisdom. Lord, they will get understanding through your Word today, God. To face the evil days that we are facing, oh God. I just thank you this evening, God, for everyone that's listening this evening. And I thank you, Lord, for your anointing upon their life also, oh God, as they read the Word, as they listen to the Word today, as I read and I share with them, Lord. They'll receive the wood and good gongs today, Father. Lord, that they will germinate and bring forth fruits in their life. Father, I thank you, Lord. As I cover the atmosphere with the blood of Jesus, Lord, I give you praise and honor this evening. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Oh, I bless God this evening, beloved. The sound of heaven is going to touch earth this evening. Amen, amen, amen. Quickly, I want to go to the word this evening, beloved. I promise to share on redeemed. Amen. By the precious blood of Jesus Christ. And to explain what is the real meaning of redemption. But before I go there, beloved, quickly, I want to read a portion of scripture so we can understand what we need to do when I share later down concerning redemption. Amen. It said here in the book of Colossians, you have your Bible. Get your Bible and your pen and paper, beloved, and mark down the scriptures. And I want you to meditate on the word of God. As the Lord told Joshua that he will be successful. Amen. So in Colossians chapter 2, verse 6. My topic here this evening quickly is rooted in Christ Jesus. And it said, as you have therefore received Christ Jesus, the Lord, so walk ye in him. Rooted and built up in him and established in the faith as you have been taught, abounding therefore with thanksgiving. 8, beloved. Beware, this is a powerful script, a powerful verse for us to meditate on. Beware lest any man spoil your thought. Spoil you through philosophies and vain deceit, after the tradition of man, after the rudiment of the world, and not after Christ. Beloved, let's continue before I share this evening, quickly. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. And ye are complete in him, which is the head of all principalities and powers, in whom also you are circumcised with the circumcision made without hands, in the putting off the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ. 12. Buried with him in baptism, wherein also you are risen with him through the faith of the operation of God, who had risen him from the dead. Beloved, I want to read that back once more, please, this evening. Buried with him in baptism. You see, beloved, we have to understand who we are in Christ Jesus. A lot of believers, we don't understand who we are in Christ, beloved. A lot of churches, a lot of leaders, a lot of people don't understand who we are in Christ. If we know who we are in Christ, what he did for us, we never live the way we live. Trust me this evening. But tonight, when I finish, beloved, you will not be fooled by no man. No man will fool you. and tell you to sow a seed for your healing. Sow a seed for your deliverance. No. This evening I'm going to open up your eyes, your spiritual eyes and your spiritual ear. That you're going to receive this word and get wisdom that you never get before. Amen. Quickly, buried with him in baptism, wherein also you are risen with him through the faith of the operation of God, who had risen him from the dead. So we are risen with him. Hallelujah. So Paul was primary concern. Paul, number one concern, beloved, was that believers will grow in spiritual maturity. That is why it's so important, beloved, to spend time making sacrifices to listen the word of God, especially when anointing men get the revelation and preach in the word of God. Amen. Position yourself to receive the word of God, and even spend time reading the word of God, meditating on the word of God. I share Friday night concerning in the book of Joshua. Quickly, who didn't heard? God told Joshua for him to be successful, he need to meditate day and night, night and day in the word of God. So I want to remind us this evening, for us to be successful, we need the word of God in us daily to be successful believers. So Paul's primary concern was that believers will grow in spiritual maturity. The basis of this conduct is Christ's leadership and indwelling. Amen? It said here quickly, the command to walk in him. There is a command, beloved, for all of us. That is in verse 6. And you have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him. That is a command for the church. To walk in him. He is in us and we are in him. That the world could see and bring glory to our Father in heaven, beloved. So it is a command for us to walk in him. The followed is followed by expression of what this involves. Being rooted mean, beloved, that when we are rooted in Christ, we stand firmly. Amen? Nobody can fool us. When we meditate in the word of God, we hear the word of God, we receive the word of God with revelation. We rooted in the word of God, beloved, we're going to stand firmly. No doctrine, no false preaching could take us away, beloved. Amen? It said there quickly. In 2 said, rooted, and verse 7 said, rooted and built up in him. Rooted and built up in him. Amen? Then it goes on to say, it says, establish, meaning confirmed. Amen? We have to know for sure that we are rooted in Christ Jesus. That we are building up our faith in Christ Jesus. Amen? And it said here, in verse 7, rooted and built up in him, and established in faith, as you have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Amen? We need to be grateful for the opportunity that we have. We need to be thankful for the redemption that takes place on Calvary, beloved. Be grateful and be happy. Be thankful for Christ redeem us. Amen? In 8, quickly, I want to share this one for us here. In 8 said, beware lest any man spoil your thoughts, spoil you through philosophies and vain deceit, after the tradition of man, after the rudiment of the world and not of Christ. The body of Christ I want to speak to today concerning this. Verse 8. I have been looking and listening very carefully. I'm here not to hit at anyone, but I'm here to help the body of Christ. I'm here to help the church. I'm here to minister the word of God to the church, to build the church. Beloved, I'm not here to break down or to pull on no one. But I want us to understand and to be very careful. The Bible said that for the tradition of men. Beware, it said here, beware is a strong warning. Listen to this carefully. There's a strong warning for the body of Christ here, beloved. And I want you to read it for yourself. In Colossians chapter 2, verse 8, said what? Look at it. Get your Bible and look at it, beloved. It said, beware. Look out. You know when you have a house or your home, most of the homes, they have a sign, beloved. You'll be blessed this evening. There's a sign saying, beware, bad dogs. When you look at that sign, you don't want to jump that gate. You don't want to go close to that gate, beloved. Because there's a sign marked, beware. This evening, I want you to look at the word of God. In verse 8 said, beware, lest any man spoil you through philosophies and vain deceit after tradition of men. Beware, beloved. Amen. So I want to encourage us this evening. If we know who we are in Christ Jesus, listen to me, we could discern the word of God, because we are filled with the Holy Spirit. Amen. And this evening, I want to go straight over concerning my message. What I promised to share this evening is redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Because if we are redeemed, we know what is the meaning of redemption. Then, which means, beloved, we'll be aware. We'll be aware of the tradition of men. Amen. We're going to be aware, glory, of the yeah, philosophies of man. Yeah, it's amen. Amen. So this evening, I want to prepare the brethren who are listening to me. Amen. And when I finish here this evening, you will be so blessed. Trust me this evening. So I want to go straight over to my message this evening. Is that the message of the Bible is basically about man's redemption from Satan's dominion by our great Redeemer, Jesus Christ. The word redeem simply means to buy back or ransom. Amen? You see, beloved, we have to understand. First,
The first man, Adam, committed high treason when he sold out the human race to God. To God's enemy, which is the devil. Amen? Man was created to rule the earth and subdue it. But when he obeyed Satan, he fell from his high position, and that's how Satan became the God of the world. And Peter talks about Satan is the God of the world, beloved. So we lose the position that we had when first God created man to take dominion, to subdue. We lose that position, beloved. But God didn't left it there. Man was originally God of this world. But he handed over that dominion to the enemy when he yielded to his temptation in the Eden. But even then, God's plan was to redeem man, beloved. God had a plan still to redeem us. No matter we lost in the beginning. There was not a person in the history of the world that was suitable, qualified to rescue man's redemption, beloved. So that God had sent his only son, Jesus, to pay the ultimate price of his precious blood, thereby obtaining redemption for all humanity, beloved. So I want to share us first this evening to understand the position that we has now. Amen. Our redemption was paid in full at Calvary, beloved. Amen. Our redemption was paid in full at Calvary cross. Over 2,000 years ago, when our Savior was crucified for us, beloved, the last word Jesus uttered while dying on the cross, it is finished. And I want you to remember that word. It is finished. Because I'm going to bring back that word, it is finished, later down in my message, beloved. Yeah. Meaning that redemption was complete for all humanity. All humanity redemption was complete. Amen. It said here, beloved, that but this man Jesus, after he had offered one sacrifice for sin forever, sat down on the right hand of God. That is Hebrews 10:12. For us to benefit from the finishing work of Christ, we must accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior, beloved. And by faith, trust his redemption, atonement to save us and give us eternal life. Beloved, we don't need to go through no man for salvation. Christ done it at the cross for us. Since we are all guilty before God, we need the blood of Jesus to redeem us from our sin. Later down the road, beloved, you're going to understand. But I'm just preparing you so that no man can fool you in times to come. It said here, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. Romans 3:23-24. Write it down, beloved. According to God's word, when we repent of our sins and accept Jesus as our Savior, as our Lord and Savior, we become born again. And as such, we are redeemed. Hallelujah. From the curse of the law of sin. Listen to this carefully. I commented a point. I commented a message I want to share for the body of Christ. For anyone or everyone want to hear this word this evening. So we have redeemed. We are redeemed from the curse of the law of sin, sickness, poverty, and eternal life. Amen. It said here, beloved, before I share, Christ had redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone that hang on a tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. Galatians 3, 13 and 14. I want you to mark down the scriptures and read it and remember it, beloved. Because when people come and preach in the word of God, or you get back to church and ministers, people come in and saying, well, sow a seed, put an envelope, sow a seed for your healing, sow a seed for your miracle, and all this kind of foolish preaching, and people are so stupid, sowing seed and giving and they're still not getting well. Let me tell you something this evening, beloved. Jesus' redemption, Jesus' redeeming, blood on Calvary, was for us. Amen. It said here again, we are redeemed from the curse of the law and sin, sickness, poverty, and eternal death. That is why Jesus Christ said, it is finished at the cross, beloved. It done, it finished at the cross. All we need to do is to bring with sin to the altar. Bring our sin to the cross. And the power of Jesus Christ, the power of the Holy Spirit, will come upon you, beloved, and heal every manner of sickness in your body. Amen. We are set free. It said here quickly, it is very important for us to keep proclaiming our redemption from under Satan's dominion. Beloved, Satan daily plotting, thinking how he could take a believer down. That is why we have to be connected. We have to be plugged on to the source of life, beloved. 24/7, we have to be plugged on to Jesus, to the word of God. In work, out of work, home, out of home. We have, beloved, and listen to me carefully. That is why the word of God is so powerful. Listen to this carefully again. I want to read it once more for us. In 2 Chronicles, chapter 2, verse 6. Hear what it said. This is why I want to come back there now. As you have therefore received Christ Jesus as Lord, so walk ye in him. Amen. He wants us to walk in him. We are in him and he are in us, beloved, to walk in him. It is very important. Amen. It said here quickly, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, who had redeemed us from the hands of the enemy. Psalm 107:2. Amen. Psalm 107:2. You are redeemed from the hands of the enemy. So no weapon formed against you, beloved, shall prosper in Jesus' name. Amen. Whatever coming, whatever attacking, let me tell you something this evening, beloved. Jesus Christ is able to do exceedingly and abundantly that you could ever think or you could ever ask for. Amen? So dear friend, this evening I want to encourage you this evening. Knowing who you are in Christ is very important. God has done everything that needed to secure our redemption. We do not need to be under any kind of bondage whatsoever. Amen? We have no reason to be under any curse, any bondage, any witchcraft, warbearism, or nothing like that, beloved. Because Jesus Christ done it at the cross. We can be free from sin and all of it, its effect in our life. Yes. Don't let no one fool you, beloved. You can be free from sin. Or every effect that it have in our life, we could be free. We could live a free life. Curse can be broken. Sickness. Curse, poverty, eliminate. All through faith in the risen Son of God. Hallelujah. Amen. So this evening, I want to pray for you this evening. I want to pray for all who listen to me. That every curse could be broken. Sickness could be broken. Poverty could be eliminated from our life. Amen. It said here quickly. For he had made himself. For he had made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God. Second Corinthians 5:21. Beloved, for he had made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him, in Christ Jesus. I shared a couple of weeks ago, or last week, that Jesus went to the cross for us, that we could become like him. So you see the purpose that we are here for, beloved? That's why we need to be rooted and we need to be grounded in him. The song sang, always, I love that song, to be more like Jesus. To be more like him. To love like Jesus, to love like him. To walk like him. Amen? But it said there quickly, watch the miracle word here now. Coming to the close. But listen this. So nobody cannot fool you, beloved. Don't let no one fool you. I say, sow a seed for your miracle. Or sow a seed for your healing. No. Listen this. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed. Amen. It's already done on Calvary. Why pay for your healing? Christ already redeemed us. He paid a price on Calvary, beloved, that you shall be healed. Why allow people to fool you? Amen. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, beloved, you are healed. Claim your healing. Go to the word of God. You see, beloved, if we have sin in our life and go to church and go for prayer for healing, can you get healed? No. No, you will not get healed if you have sin in your life. That is why most of the miracles that Jesus performed, healing miracles, what he tell him? He said, go, sin no more. What about the woman at the well? Go, sin no more. Amen? He makes sure when he performs his miracles, he says, go and sin no more. So sin is a hindrance. Sin is a blockage from us receiving our miracle. Not money. Sin. You could put a fat envelope with money and give whosoever you want to. And you have sin in your life. You're not going to receive no miracle from God. Sin separate man from God, beloved. Amen. That's why the Bible said judgment begins in the house of God. Amen. It's a fearful thing to fall in the hands of a living God, beloved. We need to deal with our life. We need to search our life. Amen. We need to do a severe in our life and see where we are falling short. So I want to encourage you again this evening, beloved. Don't let no man fool you. Don't let it come with no tradition. Tradition to bring a piece of this thing and bring this and bring that and I will pray for it and all this kind of tradition of man. No! Nobody won't tell you the truth. Repent for your sin. For the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and turn away. And let the power of God come upon your life. And heal you. Heal us. You see, beloved, no man cannot heal nobody. Christ went to the cross. He redeemed us. Amen. As I was saying here, beloved, the ransom was paid. Amen. The price was paid to Calvary. Amen. So let me, brother and I want to encourage you this evening, beloved, loved ones. Whatever situation you're facing, whatever, look, poverty, everything, brother, beloved, the favor of God could come upon people. If we just know how to connect to the source of life. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Whatever storm you're in, beloved. Look at this. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was in a fire. Yeah? They didn't want to bow to no other God. They take them and they throw them into the furnace. And they raise the heat. Beloved, when they raise the heat and they look, the church tree had four of them inside the furnace. God was with them. Amen. God was it with them. No man was there with them. No literal physical man there was with them. I could only encourage you, beloved. Amen. And I could pray for you in Jesus' name. And the power of the Holy Ghost could come upon your life. And heal you and set you free from whatever you're facing. But I'm here to let you know. It is no cost. Salvation is a free gift. So what we need is to don't put money in an envelope and put it in people's hand for your miracle. That is fooling. They're fooling you all, beloved. Wake up. Get into the Word. And read the Bible and know what the Word of God says for you. Amen. As I was sharing here earlier on, it's already done at Calvary. It finished. Our redemption was paid in full at Calvary. Amen. Over 2,000 years ago, when our Savior was crucified for us, the last word uttered by Jesus while dying on the cross for you and for me, beloved, he said, "It is finished." End of it, beloved. End of suffering. End of sickness. End of sickness. End of suffering. End of poverty. At Calvary Cross, beloved. You are free indeed. You have regained dominion. You have regained power. You have regained authority. Through Jesus Christ at the cross, beloved. We have dominion back again. The Bible said we are the head and not the tail. We are above and not beneath. We are more than conquerors through Christ who strengthens us. So you could conquer sickness, beloved, because Christ is in you. God have mercy. I'm not claiming no sickness, beloved. I'm heading up the road close to my 60s, and I will tell you something. I have no sickness. I have none. I want none. I'm not claiming none. I am well. I am blessed in Jesus' name. Every morning I declare healing in my body, beloved, in Jesus' name. Yeah? Yes, Satan is a roaring lion. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But why give him room in your life, beloved? Why sin? Why give Satan room? If once we repent, and we are born again. Listen to me. You are a child of God. And your father is going to look over you. He's going to protect you. Listen to me. If you have a child. And you go in Gulf City. Your eyes will be on that child 24/7. You will not let that child go from your hands. You're going to hold that child. And walk through the hall at the mall. Not letting that child go. I want to let you know tonight, just so it is with our Heavenly Father. He's going to hold us in the palm of His hand, beloved. And He's going to look out to Abba. He's going to walk with us. Amen. He's going to talk with us. Oh God, He's going to lead us. The Bible said that when Jesus died and He resurrected, He said, I will never leave you alone. I'm going to send another comforter, which is the Holy Spirit, to live in your car. To live in your house? To live in the garage? No. The Holy Spirit is to live in you. And to live in me. To lead us, to direct us into all truth. To lead us in the blessings of Abraham. Amen? We are Abraham's seed, beloved. We are blessed. We are highly favored. Talk to me. What we need to do sometimes, beloved, as a child of God, it's sometimes we have to thank God for the little mercies and stop complaining. Stop murmuring. Like the Israelites. Amen. God bringing them. Listen, God taking us somewhere. You know? With all this palaver taking place, God is taking us somewhere. He's possessing every person. He's taking us somewhere, beloved. Don't murmur. Don't complain. In all things, be thankful. Amen. And just stay with Him. Walk with Him. He walking with us, as I read in verse 6. Amen. Walk ye in Him. And He walk with us. He will lead us, beloved. He can lead us in victory. The Holy Spirit is going to lead us in victory. He's our comforter. He's our counselor. Sometimes, you know, we go through some stuff in life. And what we do sometimes, we're quick to do, is to pick up the phone and call somebody. And not one person, we'll call one and two and three person for advice, for counseling. And when we're done, we're more frustrated than how we was. Because we tied up hearing all sort of advice from people, from man. That is why he said, be very careful here for the tradition of man. Be careful with man. I'm not saying don't have somebody over your life, a spiritual father, sister, mother. I'm not saying no, don't have somebody that you will interact with. You will call, have one person that you trust, your spirit, bear witness with. Person walking in the spirit, living in the spirit, that you could have somebody to talk to. I'm not saying no. But do not talk to Tom, they can hurry all over about the place about your problem. They can mess you up, make it worse for you. Instead, you come and you open your Bible and you say, Lord, what you say about my problem today? Let me hear. Let me see it, Lord. Yeah? It said here in 13. I'm just sharing here quickly. Dead to the world, yet alive. You see? And you being dead in your sin and the circumcision of the flesh that had quickened together with Him, having forgiven you all trespasses. You see? So when you read that now, God speak to you. He say, what, my son? I forgive you from all your trespasses. You have been forgiven. So when I read the word of God, God speaks to you through his word. You see, sometimes we running from man for answers. Oh God, Pastor, I want a good word, I want a good word to go with. You are a good word for man. But you don't have a good word from you, from God. You see? The good word from God will set you free. That is why he said, beware. Watch your chain it, beloved. Beware. Lest any man spoil your thoughts, spoil you through philosophies and vain deceit after the tradition of man. Beware, beloved. Look out. Look out for the false prophet, the false teacher. Look out for these in this season that we are living in. They're out to con you. They're out to fool you. Take your finance away and mess up your life. No, I'm not against sowing. Not even sowing. Forget that. Sorry. I'm not against a person paying their tithes and offering. That is the word of God. Pay your tithes and your offering. Wonderful. If you're filled with the Holy Ghost, nobody do have to tell you to pay. Nobody do have to tell you to give your tithes and offering to the kingdom of God. No. But if you are paying your tithes and your offering, you need to get saved. Trust me. You need to get saved. But this sowing a seed for this and sowing a seed for that and sowing, listen to me carefully. If the Holy Spirit leads you to sow, bless God, you sow. But no man must tell you how much to sow and what to sow. That is not in the word of God. Pay your tithe and your offering, beloved. Yeah? And don't sow no seed for no healing. That is not scriptural. Yes, when you give your tithe to me, I'm going to rebuke the devourer from your life. So be faithful in giving your tithe and your offering. And he will rebuke the devourer from your life. Amen? And then you repent from your sin. And go to God. Humble yourself and go to God. Repent. Ask. Remember all the sin we commit in the days. Lord, sin I cannot remember. Oh God, forgive me. Wash me with the blood of Jesus. Wash my mind. Wash my thoughts, Lord. Wash me, Lord, with the blood of Jesus. Forgive me, Lord. We have to repent genuinely. Go to the cross, beloved. And repent for your sins. And we receive the redemption blood of Jesus. Amen. From Calvary. So my encouragement for the body of Christ today. Be aware. Be aware, beloved. Be aware. Remember that word. Go and read it. In it. Be aware. This season that we are living in. That no man deceive you. That's why it's important to meditate in the word of God. So you know the word of God. So no man can fool you, beloved. Right? So get deep in the word. You're already redeemed. You are set apart. Amen? You are a royal priesthood. Oh, God, look at what you are, beloved. You are royalty. We are royal. I don't know for you, but I am royal, you know, man. I'm highly favored. Listen to me. I'm blood washed. I'm born again. I'm happy. You have to lift your head sometime, beloved. No matter what you're going through in life. Yeah? Rise up in the morning and lift your head, beloved. Know who you are in Christ Jesus. Right? You was paid with a price. Jesus paid a price for you. Amen. To live victorious, to live blessed, to live a healing, prosperous.
Amen.
You know in the book of John, 2 John, chapter 3, I believe it is, he said, "You wish above all that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers." Amen. A threefold thing. So once your soul in order with God, healing will come. Prosperity will come. Prosperity, beloved, means wisdom. When you have wisdom, watch me, everything will fall like with Solomon. Ask for wisdom and God bless him. Bless him, double bless him. How much?
talk to me, became a wealthy man because he seek wisdom. So I pray for wisdom for you today, beloved. Seek wisdom. Go into the word. So nobody will deceive you. Nobody will fool you. Amen. I tired of hearing this sowing and this giving and you're messing up the body of Christ. Poor people here have food. Yeah? Here, take the money and go out and look. Make sure everybody in your church bless. Make sure they're happy, they have food in their house. Call up everybody and make sure they have food in their house. And they're happy. Beloved, I'm going to close now, but we need to go back in the book of Acts and live the book of Acts. Yeah? Yes. If I go to live that life and people who are in the church, they wouldn't want to come to church. When one person had to sell what they have and bless the next sister, or give her next brother things, they don't want to do that. Yeah, in the book of Acts, they used to do that, beloved. So they're fellowshipping daily. Yeah? If a sister can't pay, if I do that, you know what I mean? We need to help one another. So I bless God for you this evening. I want you to remember that you are redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Amen? You are redeemed. You are blood washed. Jesus Christ already done it at Calvary. He take back what the enemy have stolen from Adam. Jesus Christ take it back and give it to you and give it to me. So listen to me from tomorrow. Lift your head and walk. Don't walk with bondage, baggage of stress and worries and sickness and things. No. Jesus Christ brought it at the cross for us, and he gave back that death to that dominion and that authority and that power. You have power. You have power inside of you, beloved. Bubbling. Amen? Time to activate that power you have inside of you and speak to the devil and tell him what Jesus Christ done at Calvary for me and for you. Amen? Let's pray tonight. Father, I thank you, O God. Oh, hallelujah, Lord. Make us a house of prayer, Father. I pray tonight, oh God, that the fire, oh God, in the altar of your people will never burn out, Lord. But tonight, Lord, that your fire is going to kindle. Kindle the fire, oh God. Stir up the fire at the altar of the hearts today, Father, oh God. That, Lord, we're going to pray. We're going to seek your face as never before, God. No matter what we are facing, what we are going through tonight, oh God, I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, that your people are going to look at Calvary. They're going to remember at Calvary what you have done. You said, Lord, it is finished. Lord, you have bore our sicknesses at that cross. You have bore our poverty at that cross. Lord, you have bore whatever, oh God, negative in our life we have experienced, God, it finished at Calvary cross today, Father. I thank you, oh God, for redeeming us with the blood of Jesus, Lord. We are free. We are free from every bondage and every curse in Jesus' name. Lord, tonight I break every curse and every listener tonight, Lord, in Jesus' name. Curses of poverty, I rebuke it right now in Jesus' name. It has been broken. Through Calvary, Lord, it has been broken in Jesus' name. Sickness, Lord, I come against sickness right now, Father. I bring every sick person to you, Lord, right now, God. I repent on their behalf as they repent, Lord. I repent for all their sins, Lord. I pray for the power of the Holy Ghost upon them, Lord, to break that sickness right now. In Jesus' name, Lord. Loose your people tonight, Father. In Jesus' name. I remove every stress, oh God. Worries and anxiety, Lord. Remove it in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you that the Holy Spirit is going to bring peace upon them. Peace upon their home, Lord. Father, knowing who they are in Christ Jesus. Tonight, they're going to walk out in victory, Lord, tonight. Victory for the people of God. Victory tonight, Father God. I pray that, Lord, they're going to discern. As you fill them, as they baptize them with the Holy Ghost tonight and fire and power, Lord. Lord, they're going to discern. Give them the gift of discernment tonight, Lord. That they're going to discern. Black from white, they're going to discern. Who is the shepherd? And who they are following, Lord, tonight, Father. Wake up the body of Christ spiritually. Lord, Paul admonish us, Lord, to mature spiritually. I pray, God, today that every believer today, Lord, going to mature They're going to go deep in your word, God. They're going to get a revelation. They're going to mature spiritually that no one will fool them. No tradition of men will come and fool your church, Lord Father. Because God has said that you are building the church and the gates of hell will not prevail against the church. Father, I thank you for your people. Bless them tonight, oh God. Make a way for them, Lord, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Beloved, I want you to remember that God will make a way. He already made the way for us at Calvary. I just preached it. Yes? He said it is finished at Calvary, beloved. So tonight I want to leave you to walk in victory. Walk in victory because it's already done at Calvary for you and for me. Amen? So receive this word with a good spirit and walk with it. Run with it, beloved. Yeah? So I pray for you this, and I will continue praying for you all. Me and my wife will continue praying for every one of you. Amen? We love to pray and love to seek God's face. So I encourage you, be strong and be aware. Amen? Beware. Of the false prophet and false teachers. Amen. Who come in to deceive you all. Be aware, beloved. In this season that we are living in. Yeah? God bless you. Have a wonderful, blessed, and prosperous week. Friday coming, 7:30. And Sunday afternoon, I'll be here again. Amen. Equip yourself and go on Facebook and share what the Lord lay upon your heart. Same spirit in me is same spirit in you. So prepare a nice message and go and be a blessing to somebody. Beloved, if you could share and one person could hear, could change a whole course of life. Amen. But just you making one impact in a person's life. Amen. So God bless you all. Enjoy the week. In Jesus' name.